Ramily. Welcome in to Ramsaholics YouTube channel. I am your boy, Shay. This is my channel. If you're new here, make sure to subscribe. If you're returning and new, smash that like button, share with all your Rams friends, and let's get right into it. So as you can tell by the title of the video, this is a quick update on where Cooper Kupp is and if he is going to play this week. Also, my thoughts on Cooper Kupp, Puka Nacua, when he actually is back, and our outlook for the rest of the season now that we have the best wide receiver in football back. So Cooper Kupp practiced yesterday. He was listed as limited, but as Sean Mcvay said, he would not be limited. They're going to push Cooper Kupp out there, if he's healthy, to practice, to get into game shape, because this game against the Philadelphia Eagles is a really big game. This is a game that if we win, puts us in that top-tier NFC contender. And I feel that the Rams are that team. Right now, I feel that the four best teams in the NFC are all going head-to-head this week in San Fran, Cowboys, Eagles, and Rams. So it'd be really good if Cooper Kupp does come back this game. Now, good thing is the hamstring injury that was reported that he had a setback with is actually not as bad as they thought. So this is great news. Cooper Kupp is 30 years old. Hamstring injuries, once you hit 30, really can linger. We've seen it happen with a lot of top elite players, most recently DeAndre Hopkins, Julio Jones. It's a long list, and it's one of the worst injuries that you can see on an injury report because it's really unpredictable. It can act up at any time, and it can really linger all season. Actually, with Keenan Allen, we've seen this happen last year. But when he did come back, he was back, good to go, and now he's really on a hot streak. So, Cooper Kupp being back in our lineup, now you have to think about what that does to Puka Nacua. I feel this makes our offense a lot better. It makes Puka get even more open than he was. He's starting to get a lot more attention now. It really saves wear and tear on him as well as Cooper Kupp. These guys don't have to get force-fed as the clear alpha. I think it can be a split target share between these two. And then you throw in guys like Tutu Atwell, Van Jefferson, Tyler Higbee, and Kyren Williams. And you're looking at an elite group of pass catchers that the Rams have right now, led by, of course, Cooper Kupp. Puka Nacua, 39 catches, 501 yards. Cannot say this guy did not dominate the league these first 4 weeks, and that won't stop. At college, at BYU, Puka actually played on the outside more than in the slot. And if you watch on the Rams, he's all over the field. He's a do-it-all type of guy. Cooper Kupp dominates the slot. We love the advantages we get with him on a nickel or a linebacker. Especially when we throw in some motions. So this is going to be a fun offense to watch. Two guys that are selfless when it comes to the ball, they just want to win. These guys are not your typical wide receivers. They're not the divas. They're not the ones that just want to catch the ball. These guys want to get out there and get dirty. They want to block. They want to make the opposing defense fear them. Especially when we run our tight bunch formations, it's going to be a lot of fun. So Cooper Kupp, Puka, they're going to really dominate the inside route tree, but they have a route tree that could expand. Then you're going to have Tutu Atwell. I think we're going to really get him some deep balls now. So this is going to spread the opposing defense more. Cooper Kupp is, in my opinion, the best wide receiver in football. Smart, great footwork, great route runner, great blocker, does it all, great teammate. There's nothing that this guy cannot do. And he also is underrated when it comes to jump balls because he can get up there and get the ball. It's going to be a great thing seeing these two together along with Tutu Atwell, who's made a huge jump in year three. Now, rest of the season with Cooper Kupp back. Of course, we got to hope that everybody stays healthy, but at this moment, we're getting on track. We did what we needed to do. We went 2-2 while Cooper Kupp was on IR. A lot of people had us going 0-4, 1-3. We played three playoff teams from last year, and now we have our fourth in five games. So our schedule really starts hard. So we're going 500 with Cooper Kupp coming back, who is arguably the most important wide receiver to a team in football, maybe the most important weapon on an offense in football. You could probably say Christian McCaffrey, but then you have to put Cooper Kupp at the two. As far as what he's going to do to this offense, we've seen him win a triple crown. We've seen him win a Super Bowl MVP. Cooper Kupp's always talked about in the top five, but you never see him talked about as the top guy. He's the top wide receiver. You can make an argument for Justin Jefferson, and I'll listen to it. But other than that, and Davante Adams as well. But other than that, I mean, Cooper Kupp and them guys, they're in a tier of their own. Jamar Chase could be up there as well. But I'll take Kupp, Adams, and Jefferson as my top three wide receivers in football. And this game this week against the Philadelphia Eagles, I will be doing my game preview tomorrow, and I'm also doing a co-stream with JC Sports, who's a Philadelphia Eagles content creator. It is super crucial that Cooper Kupp is healthy, and that's what Sean McVay said, 80 to 90% or he's not playing. He wants him to be out there and be his full self. He doesn't want to rush him back. This is great. So if he does come back against the Eagles, we have him at his full strength. I would love to see him against these Eagles. Their secondary has been getting torched this year. They let guys like Mac Jones torch him, Sam Howell. So I'm very confident that Stafford could have his best game this year. He is second in passing yards. The one thing that Cooper Kupp brings that these other receivers don't yet is Cooper Kupp in the red zone. Is a great target. He scores a bunch of touchdowns with Stafford. They have that chemistry. Puka finally had his first touchdown of the season. Tutu Atwell has a touchdown as well, but Cooper Kupp would probably have Stafford in the top five passing touchdowns right now if he was healthy. So Stafford's going to be improved. This offense is going to be rocking. Ramily. Thank you all for your continued support. We just hit 300 subscribers. I appreciate you all. As I mentioned, subscribe, like, share, turn on your post notifications. I'm giving between shorts, lives, and videos. I'm trying to do about 10 videos a week. There's a lot of good things happening with our Los Angeles Rams right now, and we should be very thankful. So, hey, take care of yourself. Take care of your loved ones. I'm your boy, Ramsaholic, and I'm out.